island of dreams in the Indian Ocean and part of the largest island kingdom in the world, the state of Indonesia. Selamat datang. Welcome to paradise. Temples, volcanoes, rice terraces, dance and religion. Denpasar has been the capital of Bali since 1946 and was once the seat of homonymous principality of Badung. In 1953, the Pura Jagatnata, the temple of the ruler of the world, was consecrated to the supreme god. This, the city's oldest Hindu temple, dates from the 14th century and was established by the envoy of the Majapahit Empire. The rear section has been well preserved and dates back to the early days of Javanese colonization. Most of the shrines were destroyed by earthquake but subsequently rebuilt. Every effort was made to ensure that the original design was maintained in order to retain the dignity of the sacred images. In 1910, the Bali Museum was established as a symbol of political reconciliation with the Dutch. The buildings are a combination of classic Balinese temple and palace architecture. Located in the northeast of the island is Klung Kung, former capital of the dynasty of the same name. As the former seat of Dewa Agung, the supreme of God, and the highest ranking of the Balinese Rajas, for many centuries Klung Kung held a special importance. Raja's palace was a cultural center for all of Bali and also a center of power. And in the Hall of Justice, judgments were duly rendered. Further north, on the slopes of the Gunung Agung volcano, is Bali's largest religious sanctuary, the country's first state temple of Pura Besaki. On special occasions, thousands of Balinese Hindus visit this, the mother of all temples, where authentic religious dance performances entertain the faithful. At the temple, there's a sumptuous feast, and sacrifice becomes an entertainment. It's not known when the first sanctuary was built here, but it would have been before the arrival of the first Hindus. Again and again, earthquakes destroyed several sections of the temples. Yet the destructive flows of lava spared the holy shrines of Besaki. One more reason to visit the gods. The last Raja built a royal bath on the slopes of the Agung volcano. He named it Tirtha Ganga, holy water of the goddess Ganga. In the pools situated among beautiful paddy fields, both rulers and their kinfolk were at home here. In the past, the gardens, roads, bridges, water pools and pavilions were only accessible to the Balinese nobility. The near east coast at Kandidasa may not be ideal for swimming. It's an area where there was once a village whose occupants worked on the production of salt. Now less profitable and so worked by only a few. With With great effort, the salty seawater is dragged to sandy fields and poured out. The sand, soaked with salt water, is placed into a vat. The brine crystallizes, and white gold is created. Not far away, located on the coast, is the Bat Temple of Goalawa, a natural phenomenon of the underworld. Here, the mystical snake, Bazuki, is worshipped, a creature that feeds on bats. The faithful pray and offer sacrifices before various shrines, beyond which the cave contains thousands of bats. The streets around Ubud are full of artisans. Many silversmiths produce filigree works of art. Also, stone statues, often weighing more than half a ton, are the result of much laborious work. Most of the products are supplied to temples and hotels. Balinese painting also developed at the royal court, all of it religious and also anonymous. Woodcarvers create popular masks made from local timber, while the tourists watch in fascination. The motifs represent gods, demons, and heroes from Hindu history. At the entrance to the monkey forest near the town of Ubud, the famous saint monkeys welcome those who come here. Cheeky little macaques are thought to be descendants of mythical monkey king Hanoman. It's thought that around 600 monkeys have always guarded the temple of the death goddess Durga, a task that makes them hungry. In 1923, one of the oldest monuments in Bali was discovered, the elephant cave of Goa Gaja. A demon guards the entrance to this man-made cave. Its dark interior indicates that here Ganesha, the elephant-headed son of Shiva, has been worshipped. Near Bangli, former center of the Kingdom of Bangli, is Pura Kaen, which is also known as the Treasure House Temple. Statues in the style of Wayang Kulit figures flank 38 steps, up to the Kulkul Tower and the Kori Agung Gate. Chinese porcelain plates are embedded in the wall of the courtyard on the upper terrace. Due to their foreign origin, they were considered to be precious. Various temple guards set in stone guard the 11 shrines of the inner sanctuary, the Jeroan. Exceptional stone carvings adorn the Padmasana, the divine throne of the Trimurti, Shiva, Brahma, and Vishnu. On Bali, the range of volcanoes continues. The active Gunung Batur volcano, just in the north of the island, is the country's second most sacred mountain. Steep and bumpy roads lead from the rim down to a dark, lava-field-covered caldera. Up until 1917, this was the location of the village of Batur. But when the volcano erupted for the first time in the 20th century, it buried the entire village under a layer of deadly lava. The caldera was formed millions of years ago. Its crater lake is in the shape of a crescent. Surprisingly, the settlement of Batur was relocated to the rim of the crater, and another temple was built there. Colorful umbrellas, gold-painted gates, winged demons, and stylized snakes, wherever you look. The shrines are dedicated to various deities and are guarded by fancifully decorated stone figures. Ornate gates and various steps lead to a second courtyard that is surrounded by several shrines. Its inauguration ceremony was held on April the 14th, 1935, and it's commemorated each year. Gamelan music and Legong dance are part of Bali's culture. The movement of the body, and especially the position of the head, the play of the eyes and various facial expressions, each form the traditional elements of the dance. The dance originates from the royal courts of the last century, and tells the story of a princess who has lost her way and is offered sanctuary by a king. Even today, many girls dream of becoming a famous Legong dancer. To accomplish this entails a lengthy training period, rewarded by performances up and down the country. A journey to the center of the island, from Sebali to Keliki, is a great experience and one not to be missed. Uphill through small villages and lush greenery, past banana trees and paddy fields. Typical Balinese country life. Rice is Bali's staple diet. And this thousands of years old landscape architecture forms the perfect backdrop to this requirement. In Tegaladan, the impressive rice terraces can be seen from the opposite hill of a small river valley. Not far away on the upper reaches of the Pakaraisan River is the revered sacred source of the Teta Empul Holy Spring. Since the 10th century, magic healing powers have been attributed to its pure spring water. At the fourth full moon of the year, residents of the nearby village use a sacred stone in order to clean the spring. Legend has it that it was here that God Indra scratched the earth and created the spring whose water gave immortality to his divine legions. A short distance downriver is the almost hidden Gunung Kawi, a long stairway of stone steps that leads through lush green vegetation down to the river. Well disguised, a rock wall suddenly appears with several candies, more than 7 feet high niches with a facade of stone sarcophagi. they're massive grave monuments for godlike royalty. Without an interior, the candies are stone reliefs. In a traditional Balinese home, many generations live together. Each family has its own sleeping quarters, whose furniture varies according to age group. In the courtyard, there are shrines which serve as a seat of honor to numerous deities during their visit to Earth. Sangay also is located near Ubud, where there is a monkey forest. In the midst of the dark forest is the mystical green moss-covered Pura Bukit Sara temple that dates back to the 17th century. These speedy monkeys, when fed, quickly make friends, but also demand an appropriate reward for their entertaining performances. In the cool highlands of the north is Bratan Lake and its temple located in the caldera of a primeval and long extinct volcano. Pura Urundanu is situated on a small headland in the temple. The life-giving goddess of the waters is worshipped by the region's inhabitants. This temple complex was built by the Raja of Mangui for Shiva and Vishnu in the early 17th century. Apart from these deities, others may also be worshipped here. On our return journey to the south of the island are the picturesque paddy fields of Jatiluwi, a fascinating, picturesque landscape. The rice farmers became landscape architects and created skillfully shaped rice terraces that have now become a popular photograph motif. A little remote and surrounded by a mountain forest, from a clearing suddenly appears one of Bali's holiest temples, Pura Luhur Batu Kau. Here Mahadewa, deity of the Batu Karu volcano, is worshipped, and for whom there is a shrine in each of West Bali's temples. Their ancestors also worshipped the Rajas of Tabanan in a three tumpang meru. A wet and slippery route leads down to a mountain stream in the vicinity of the temple, where there is a stone throne and a tiny shrine. Further south, near Mangui, is the Temple of the Beautiful Garden. The second largest sanctuary after Pura Besaki. The Pura Taman Ayun complex is surrounded by a wide moat, well laid out courtyards and shrines. All of its grandeur and significance is explained by builder Igusti Agongonom, who founded the powerful kingdom of Mangui. The Barong dance that is performed outside the temple scenery is certainly an impressive experience for any visit to Bali. Soon, Barong appears with a lion mask embodied by two dancers, front and rear. mythical creature is accompanied by masked dancers. Between them, temple dancers appear and attempt to delight the gods with their dance. Here, evil fights good. Again and again, the battle ends without result because good and evil go together like night and day, like both brightness and darkness. At the most southerly is a peninsula that contains Nusa Dua, where several hotels have been built since the early 1970s, such as the Ayodhya Resort, Bali. The entrance resembles an altar with deities, and everywhere there are shrines, statues, and traditional decorations. The courtyard is a watery landscape framed by an assortment of residential buildings. And the beach offers well-tended lawns to fine sand. In the east of the peninsula, the establishment of the GWK Cultural Park began in the 1990s. A huge Garuda bird is above the rocks, and the head of a large bronze statue of Hindu god Vishnu. It was planned to be 66 meters high, but this was only enough for its head and upper body. Close by is the southernmost tip of the grandiose Uluwatu Temple, again guarded by monkeys. This is a state temple dedicated to Dewi Danu, patron goddess of the sea. It's located high above the sea on top of the cliffs, which drop perpendicularly into the sea. At dusk, the nearby open-air theatre is the ideal setting for an atmospheric performance of Kichak Chak, or monkey dance. Costumed dancers are surrounded by up to 100 men, seated in a circle and calling for Kichak. The dancers from the Ramayana legend are accentuated dramatically by a male chorus, and the sound of battle is created by human voices. The modern Kichak is very popular with tourists. Back on the main island in Kuta, are wonderfully spacious white sandy beaches and the warm Indian Ocean, often with waves several meters high. Here, relaxation is the order of the day, and the waves attract surfers from all over the world. The Pura Tanalo Temple is wonderful and should be on any holiday agenda. Its location on a small rocky peak about 50 meters off the rugged southwest coast is quite captivating. The crowds that come here have also attracted many tradesmen to the mainland. And even at sunset, it's quite busy. Bali is the island of the gods, with fantastic scenery, fascinating culture, and exclusive hotels. Exotic beauty, dream destination, tropical paradise.